So you just got a Nikon camera, but don't know which memory card to get. Let's find out which one is the best one for your camera. Hey everyone, Camber here, back with you. And today I want to tell you what is the best memory card for video for your Nikon camera. And if you're new here, this channel is all about teaching you how to use your camera to make good videos, so consider subscribing. Now, a while back, I made another video about what all the different numbers on memory cards mean and how to choose the best one based on your camera's max recording bitrate. But the most common question I still get asked on that video is, hey, I just got this camera, what's the best memory card for it? So let me know down in the comments which camera you're using. So what I'm gonna do in this video is group these Nikon cameras by their max recording bitrate and show you what card I suggest, as well as how much recording time that will give you when filming at that highest rate. And I have links for all the cards down below in the description so you can check that out once you find out which card you need for your camera. And I also have timestamps below so you can find your camera model and skip ahead to see what you'll need. And if anything I say here is confusing as far as card sizes or speed class ratings, just go check out this other video I made here about what all the different numbers on the memory cards mean, and then you'll understand what we're talking about here. So the first two cameras we'll look at are the D610 and the D7100, which both have a maximum recording bitrate of 24 megabits per second. And for these, I recommend this 32 gigabyte card, which will allow you to shoot at full HD for just under 3 hours. And the card sizes I'm suggesting here are based on my own personal minimum of 2 hours of shooting time, so that when I'm at live events like a wedding, I can leave my cameras rolling and not have to worry about running out of space. But if you think you need more time, then you can just go with the next higher size up, and that'll double your recording time. Or if you think you need less time, just go with the next size down, and that'll be half the time. Next up, we have the D750, which shoots at a maximum of 28 megabits per second. And for this camera, I suggest the same 32 gigabyte card. However, since it shoots at a higher bit rate of 28 megabits per second, which will give you better quality, it'll give you full HD for just over 2.5 hours. Next up, we have the D5300, which shoots at a maximum of 38 megabits per second. And for this camera, I suggest a 64 gigabyte card, which will allow you to shoot at full HD for about 3 hours and 45 minutes. Next, we have the D810, which shoots at a maximum of 42 megabits per second. And for this camera, I suggest the same 64 gigabyte card. However, because it does have that higher bit rate of 42 megabits per second, it'll only give you about 3 hours and 23 minutes of recording time at full HD. And the last group of cameras that shoots at a maximum of 144 megabits per second, we have the Z6, the Z7, the D850, D5, D500, and D7500. And for these cameras, I suggest this 128 gigabyte U3 card, which will allow you to shoot at 4K for just under 2 hours. And those are the best memory cards that I suggest for video for these various Nikon cameras. And again, I have links down below in the description for all the cards, so you can find the one that I talked about for your camera. Click on the link and it'll take you right over to what you need. If you do have any more questions, just leave them down in the comments. I'll try to clarify anything I can. If this video is helpful, go ahead and leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you soon.